Hello dear, welcome to Android task-based learning with Java. So in this time we are going to perform the practical programming session with Sigbar and TextView. So totally based on Android Studio 4.0. Deal with the skill means in this task you will get whatever the component you need to design or you need to deal with that particular listeners and all those values. So Sigbar and TextView. Currently, in this tutorial, we are going to deal with these two components or widgets, Sigbar and TextView. So, task to do or task to perform it is set RGB model with Sigbars. Change the values of Sigbars. It should be affected to screen background of color with the screen. So, using view binding, what should be the final output of your task? It can be like this one. If you reduce that, then the value will be shown on the text view also and screen will be affected by that way also. Likewise for the red, green and combination of all those three values also affected to screen background color. So it is the task, very easy task and you can do it, I assure that, but it is a little bit logical also. So you need to perform the task which will be affected. Likewise, screen color, whatever the screen will be affected with red, not only with the red, but the combination of these three Sigbars. So it is the basic logic behind this three Sigbars value exercise. So pause the video, you know that what to do. And after the completion of the task, play this video. Hello, I am sure that you have completed your task and as per the Android guideline, upgrade your studio to Android 4.0. And why we are using view binding? Because we don't want to deal with the find view by IDs. So we are going to use view binding because if we are using view binding, then it will be beneficial for much more component in the screen. So let's start Android task based learning with Java. So create one new project with empty activity inside the Android Studio 4.0. It's a OTS, means one time task, where you have to write view binding enable equals to true. Make sure your internet connection is on. After that, design main screen. Likewise, three Sigbars, one for red, one for green and one for blue, you have to take. If you are aware about the values, then by default Sigbars highest value is 100, you need to make it with 255 because combination is 255, 0 to 255 means total 256 colors, highest value with that. So if you are aware about the colors or colors.color.rgb, then you are aware about it. 0 to 255 means individual colors highest value is 255 in Java programming side. So combination of these three Sigbars, you have to design the screen. Likewise, three Sigbars and three text views. And after that, you have to code inside main activity. So let's start our programming. And over here, go to file, then new project with empty activity. Click on next and just type demo, whatever the name you want to give. TBL means task based learning system. I think it will be beneficial for all the learner because sometimes task assignment is very useful to powerful our concept. Click on finish. All the steps are ready. Make sure your internet connection is on. Then for the view binding, we have to write inside build.gradle file view binding enabled equals to true. And click on sync now. After the syncing process will be finished, our project is capable to process with all the components with view binding. So we don't have to write after that find view by IDs. So just type activity main binding, it is automatically generated class activity main binding. So initialize the binding value. Likewise, activity main binding dot inflate get layout inflated. Very good. And set content view, just refresh this one, binding.getroot. Okay, so we will deal with the three values afterwards. First we design our screen. So let's design our screen with sig bar. First give the ID, the sig bar for red, so there is no text. Top to top of all the things are right, I don't want to. Bottom to bottom of, and certain margin on the top side, margin top, I think 20 dp is enough. Okay, so always set that maximum value is 255. Then if you want to set the progress, means current by default value when the program is loaded will be loaded at that time, sig bar at 255. So sig bar value is ready, width is match parent always with this one. So I just type padding of 10 dp on the constraint layout. Also give the ID to constraint layout, likewise at the red plus ID and background. Just I want to set that particular constraint layout background, so that's why I give the ID to that. So copy paste is the best thing. So control C, I just want one text view, so that's why I am text view, then it is TV red. Okay, so remove this top to top of, inside that top to bottom of at the rate plus ID and sig bar red. All the things I think I it is right, but there is no max and there is no progress, so only text size will be 30 sp and text color will be black. So if you want to write certain text by default, then red is the value. So let's see and check it out. Yes, it's good one. The design is perfect as per my mind. Just copy this one and paste it for the green one. So green, it is not top to top of, it's top to bottom of at the red TV red. Okay, then all the other things are right, correct. It's a TV green, and just type SB green. All the things are perfect on this place, and just I want to see. Okay, so red, sig bar red and text view red, sig bar green and text view green is here. Just control C and control V, it is for the blue. Then after the TV green, it will be sig bar for blue, and this is blue again. After this, sig bar value of blue. So just check it out, three sig bars and three text views with one constraint layout ID with the background. So all the stuffs are ready over here, you can see this one. So just I am going to this way, just I type integer red equals to highest value of 255, green equals to 255 and blue equals to 255. Just I press semicolon, and I want to set that particular with binding dot whatever the value, means background dot set background color. So color dot RGB is the value, if you know that color dot RGB, where you can set red, green and blue. So just I type red and green and blue. Okay, so by default it is set it by that way, and also I want to set certain progress, likewise binding dot TV red dot set text red equals to what are the value of red, it is on the argument. So just I type for the green and for the blue, just write green value is here and blue is here. So if you want to set with certain by that way, also you can do it, and green and blue. Okay, so all the things are ready with that. Just we do one thing, that binding dot whatever the sigbar red dot set on sigbar change listener. Mind well that if you deal with certain component, then each listener, whatever the we have to deal with that component, you have to remember. So set on sigbar change listener is here. So new space and control space, and give that away. So there are three methods. One is after on the stop tracking touch, start tracking touch, but we deal with this one. So just I copy this one, and I know that what I have to do. So I type red equals to progress. Already given variable, what are the values will be changing as per the changing of or tracking of sigbar, it will be affected to the progress, and it will be written inside the progress. So just we set red equals to progress. So same you have to deal with all others, means for the green, just I type green, and green equals to progress we need to write, because we have to write for the all, means red, green and blue, the simultaneous effect of that particular it will be affected with program background color. So and one more time, just we need to write for the blue. So it is for the blue one. So blue is the progress, and over here we need to write blue equals to whatever the value we will get. So all the things, I think it is ready with this one. So just I type and run this one. So press shift F10 and just check it out, whatever the output or desired output we will have or not. So let's do it. Press shift F10. Gradle building is running. After the finish, it is right now on the screen. So highest value red equals to 255. So you know the combination of, if you I make it red equals to 0, then combination of highest value of green and blue is here. So if I again lesser the sign of green, likewise this way, then blue is highest. If you want combination of red and blue, then you can higher the values or track the values to the red sigbar. If you make it by this way, then it will be black. So very nice example we have done with this one. So red, green and blue. If you want to check only red, then this is the output. Likewise, red is highest and green and blue is 00. So if you set or if you know the RGB and hash sign, then practical will be useful. Likewise, F00, it is current right now. If you set 0F0, then it is green. Then if you want to set 00F, then it is blue. Likewise, this one. So it is the basic of that, and our sigbar with the text view. I know that it's a little bit logical. If you aware about the sigbar set on change listener, then it is easy for you. But two things you need to mind: how to set background color and color. What is the color dot RGB? So by default, what are the values? If you aware about this one, then it will be much more beneficial to you. So task-based learning system, basically you can find or you boost up your skill to deal with certain components and their listeners. So it is also for the beginner, or it is also for to help to, if you want to sharpen our skill on the basis of particular components. So Android task-based learning system with Java, sigbar and text view, it is completed. So thanks for watching. How to deal with sigbars, and according to that, on the changing of the position and text view will be affected and background color will be affected. So keep coding, be happy, then like this video, comment your inside the comment section, and subscribe this channel. Thank you very much.